schedule was released yesterday, and in this video, we're going to go game-by-game prediction on the Lions' schedule. And without further ado, let's get this thing started. Go ahead and hit that like button right now. Let's get the 300 likes in this video. With you, it absolutely can happen. More likes you get, the more chance that Chat Sports gets off my 2 points of contact. Let's go ahead and get this thing started right now here. As you know, schedule came out last night. Let's do game-by-game prediction. Let's get this thing going here. Now, first off, it's way too early, right? We don't even know what players are going to be on for the teams. There could be injuries and all sorts of stuff, but we can only go pie with what we got. So let's get this thing started. And I already know I'm going to get destroyed, at least from the beginning part, for being a homer here, but this is how I believe. So the Lions, week one, Sunday night football, Detroit, Goff versus Stafford 2.0, or actually be 3.0. Remember year one, we actually went to L.A., but Stafford's returning back to Detroit. I do have the Lions winning this game. I think they are the better football team. I already beat them last year, and it's, you know, the crowd's going to be hyped after last year. An opening game on Sunday Night Football against Stafford. Man, you're going to be hearing the Jared Goff chants. It's going to be going cray-cray. Let me know in the comment section right now. Who do you got winning the game? Do you got the Rams upsetting the Detroit Lions, or do you have the Lions beating the Rams? L for Lions, R for Rams. Blow up the comment section right now. Okay, next game here, Tampa Bay Buccaneers coming to the Detroit Lions, and yay. So I think the Lions are the better team again. I have the Lions winning this game. Why do I think they're the better team? Because you just look at the roster, the Lions are a better team right now. Carlton Davis gets his revenge, right? He can come in there and go against his former team after the trade. And the Lions going 2-0. Continue here. Arizona Cardinals. A lot of people's going to assume this is going to be an easy game. I'm just tell you right now, it's not going to be easy. They fight very tough over there in Arizona, and now they actually got more talent than what they had last year. So I have the Lions winning this game, but it's not a gimme just because it says Arizona Cardinals. I don't think it's a gimme at all. And it's hard to play over there in Arizona. We've had hard times over there, but still, I think the Lions win the game. But not a gimme. Seattle Seahawks again. We love playing, apparently, Seattle at our house. We play them every year now. It seems like it's becoming almost an NFC North rivalry because we play them all the time. We have lost this game years in a row. It is time for the Detroit Lions to win this game. The Lions winning this game, finally getting a win over the Seattle Seahawks. Lions are 4-0. Bye week. We're going to win the bye week. Then we got to go to Dallas. Of all the teams that I want to beat on this schedule, Dallas Cowboys is number one. I know you'd say, oh, why not the 49ers or the Rams, blah, 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 blah. It's the Dallas Cowboys. The two-point conversion has me salty. 2014, the Pettigrew pass interference still has me salty. I want to go into Jerry's world and beat them fair and square. I have the Lions winning this game. I do. But it's going to be difficult. We can't just say, oh, it's automatically the Lions going to win. I think we are the better talented team, but they have the better talented referees. And it seems like every single time something happens. So I'm going to go with the Lions winning this game, going 6-0. The odds of the Lions being 5-0 at this point is extremely unlikely. Well, I wouldn't say extremely unlikely. It's unlikely. Right? You're generally going to miss a game. You're going to fall off a game. But just by talent and sheer willing to the Dallas Cowboys' existence, Lions win this game. At Minnesota Vikings, I don't think Minnesota's going to be the greatest team in the world here. Of all the teams on the schedule, I think Minnesota's probably one of the easier teams. And it's not really downgrading the Vikings. It's because we have a very tough schedule. But they also got a rookie quarterback if he's playing by then. What, week seven, Sam Darnold is the starter. McCarthy's probably playing by them. Even if Darnold is still playing, I think the Lions are just a better team. Lions win the game. The Tennessee Titans. This may be the easiest game on the schedule. And I have the Lions winning this game. They're just the better football team. I don't really need a whole lot of explaining. I feel like they need a lot of upgrades over there on that team. They're just not as good. And it's at home in Detroit. So, yeah, Lions win this game. Week 9, we're traveling to Green Bay. And I got to say this. I have the Lions losing this game, not because we're not the better team or anything like that. It's hard to go to Lambeau, even though we've done it the last couple years, but Green Bay has upgraded the talent. I'm sure they're very upset that we keep beating them in Lambeau Field as of late. So I got the Green Bay Packers winning this game. We're starting out 7-1. That would be crazy. We're 8-1. 7-1. Houston Texans, this is going to be the game of the year for me. Epic game right here. Houston Texans very well could be representing the AFC in the Super Bowl. Lions could be representing the NFC in the Super Bowl. Could be a Super Bowl preview. I have Lions losing this game. It's going to be a tough game over there in Houston. They're a great team. Got us losing this game. What do you guys have? Who wins? Lions, L for Lions, T for Texans. Let me know in the comments below. Jacksonville Jaguars at home. Lions going to win this game. I think they're the better football team. This is an up-and-down team. It's cold, hot. It's bipolar. It's a weird team because they have a lot of talent there, but they don't win. So I'm going to go ahead and say the Lions win this game. It could switch. What if they end up being really good? We don't know. That's a team you just don't know. At Indianapolis Colts, a lot of I don't knows here. Is Anthony Richardson going to be playing? What does their team look like? They were competitive last year, and if they get their quarterback back, they're going to be better, in my opinion. So I'll say we take the loss here at Indianapolis and get another loss on the record because you can't win them all. That's a flip of the coin. It really is a flip of the coin team because you don't really know what they got going on. Chicago. Oh, we're going to win this game. We'll win this game. A lot of these Bears fans have been talking a lot of garbage. And it's at Ford Field on Thanksgiving. We need the win on Thanksgiving. It's got to happen. Lions win this game. Two losses, rest wins. Green Bay comes to our house. We're not getting swept. That's Ford Field. Yeah, we beat Green Bay this time. So we split. Buffalo Bills at Ford Field. Tough, tough, tough game, but I think they're not as good as maybe people think they are. I think their window kind of slipped away a little bit. I think they're on the down end. We get revenge after the Thanksgiving Day game a couple years ago. We beat the Bills. At Chicago Bears, we take the loss here. They get revenge and they beat us. We take the loss on this one. At San Francisco, I say we take the loss on this one as well. Why do I think that? Because it's going to be really tough to go to San Francisco late in the year. We're beat up already. Our bye week is early. That doesn't do us a whole lot of favors here. So I'm going to say that we lose this game. So four losses so far. And Minnesota Vikings, it could be a coin flip. What if the Lions aren't really playing for much? They got everything locked up. I know last year that we played this game. We'll probably do it again. coin flip again. You know what? Between this game here, because you don't know what's going to be on the line, right? The Indianapolis game, the Jaguars game. A lot of games that it's hard really to determine wins and losses because you don't know the team yet. So I think I had 13 wins. I'll drop it down to 11 to 12. That's what I got here. So I with the Vikings, I'll just go win, even though that puts me at 13. Somewhere else we take a loss. 11-12 win season again. I think that's what it seems like. We got an interesting part of this schedule that not a lot of people's talking about. The Lions are outside three games out of the whole NFL schedule. Their whole schedule. Think about that. There's 17 games. Three of them are outside. One of them in San Francisco. At least it's going to be warm there, week 17. Then at Chicago and at Green Bay. That is all our outside games. Everything else is in a dome. So that's favorable towards the Detroit Lions. So that's favorable. The bye week is not favorable. Terrible bye week. We always get the bye week early, and that's just the way it is, how it happens. But in all honesty, to have this many dome games, 9 home games, it's not a bad schedule. So I'm going to go with 11 to 12 wins right there. What do you guys think? What do you guys have for the Lions win-loss record? That's going to be the pinned comment for this video. Blow up the comment section with your thoughts. We're going to be dropping videos still every single day. Training camp's coming up here in a couple months. And that's when it doesn't end, folks. It just keeps going and going and going. So hit that notification bell. Subscribe to the channel so you don't miss out on the latest Lions news and rumors. Adios.